Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about MATLAB implementation of unified power quality conditioner for power quality improvement in power system. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So this is general configuration of UPQC. It consists of two filter. So one is series active power filter, another one is shunt active power filter. So the series active power filter connected in series with the power system. So shunt active filter connected in parallel with the power system. The series active power filter used to for mitigate the voltage disturbance and harmonic in the power system by injecting the voltage. The shunt active filter used to for compensate the reactive power in the power system by injecting the current. And also the shunt active filter used to for regulate the DC link voltage for both filters. So this is the main operation of that UPQC. Next we have to see about MATLAB implementation of UPQC. First I am going to explain about the power system operation without UPQC. So this is the Simulink model. The model does not have UPQC. It have only source and load. The source I am going to use the line to line amplitude equal to 400. The frequency is 50 Hz. And I am going to create the scenario. Voltage disturbance scenario and harmonic disturbance scenario. That means I am going to create voltage sag and voltage swell, and also I am going to inject the harmonic voltage in the system. So for that I am going to make the amplitude of that input source voltage is 1 per unit, 0.7 per unit, 1, 1.3, 1. And timing for that amplitude variation is 0 to 0.9 and 1 second, 1.6 and 1.7. So this is to for creating that voltage sag and swell. Okay, so these two things used to for generating the harmonic voltage in the input source. Here I am going to generate 5th and 7th harmonic during a time 0.3 to 0.4 second. So this is used for creating that voltage sag and swell scenario, as well as injection of harmonic voltage in the power system. Here I am going to use a non-linear load. So here the non-linear load is considered as a rectifier with the RL load. So this load is operated at a THD of around 22.24%. Next I am going to simulate this model. So you will get the idea about the source voltage and current and the load voltage and current. So this is going to be used for measuring the source voltage and current, and this is used for measuring the load voltage and current. So this is source voltage and current. So here you can see that. So this is generation of harmonic in the source voltage. So this is generation of voltage sag. That means the amplitude change from 1 per unit to 0.7 per unit. So this is generation of voltage swell. That means amplitude change from 1 per unit to 1.3 per unit. And then this is a input source current variation. So the current is not sinusoidal in nature, it have some distortion. So next you have to check the THD of the source current. Now you can see that the THD of the source current is around 22.2%. So I'm going to use scope data. That means, so data stored in the here, right? Scope data. So I'm going to use that data. So input only is voltage, right? So voltage no problem. The THD around 0. Input to is current. You can see that the THD around 22.2%. Okay, so this is normal operation of the power system without using any power quality improvement device. Okay, so next I'm going to use the power quality improvement device. Here I'm going to use UPQC, Unified Power Quality Conditioner. Okay, so here this point known as a point of common coupling. So this is known as series active power filter, and this shunt active power filter is connected, series active power filter connected by a transformer in series with the this line, and shunt active power filter is connected in parallel with the this point. Okay, so next I'm going inside that series active power filter. So here I'm going to use active power element, nothing but IGBT. So otherwise we can call it as converter or inverter. So this block used to for generating and getting pulse for that voltage source inverter. Here I'm going to measure the load voltage, and then it's going to process via this controller, and it's going to be generate the pulse for that voltage source inverter in order to mitigate the sag, swell and harmonic problem in the source voltage. So inside that controller it has this block. This block nothing but this is used for generating reference for that hysteresis controller. So this reference going to be compared with the load voltage here. After comparing the error, signal is processed by hysteresis controller. This hysteresis controller going to be generate the pulse for that voltage source inverter. So this voltage source inverter is going to be inject some voltage in order to improve the source voltage, improve the voltage in the power system at the load side. So next I am going to open that shunt active filter. Already I told shunt active filter used to for compensating reactive power in the power system as well as improve the power quality of the source current, and also it going to be used to for maintaining the DC link voltage between series and shunt active filter. So this is a block inside that shunt active filter. So this is also has one inverter connected via coupling inductor. So this is going to be act as a current source inverter for injecting the current in the power system in order to compensate the reactive power. So this is a controlling part for the shunt active filter. Here I'm going to measure the voltage across the shunt active filter, that means DC voltage, DC link voltage. And then going to be compare with some reference voltage. Here I'm going to fix reference voltage is 700, and it's going to be processed via PA controller. So this control going to be control the voltage, DC link voltage, or it going to be regulate the DC link voltage. So this controller provide the control signal. So it going to be considered as last power for the next stage. So this is nothing but this plus nothing but this is going to be used for generating the compensating current. Okay, so it going to be received three input. So one is from PA controller, so another one is from the source voltage, another one is load current. So this is processed via PQ block. So this block used to for generating the real and reactive power and P naught I naught calculation. So it receive two input VABC and IL. So based upon VABC IL, we are going to calculate PQ P naught I naught. So this is a block inside that PQ block. So here the equation is to for calculating P, Q, I naught and P naught. So after that it process via that mean low pass filter and some calculation is done in order to generate actual real and reactive power. So this is inverse PQ block. So here we are going to convert that the PQ quantity into a compensating current. So for that you have to use this block. Okay, so this is the block used to for generating the compensating current from the previous block. Okay, so these are the equation used to for generating compensating current. Okay, normally in this two block is going to be we are going to use that transformation, three phase to two phase transformation, like a Clark transformation, inverse Clark transformation. Okay, so by means of that Clark inverse Clark transformation, we are going to generate the compensating current. So it going to be act as a reference current for the next stage. Okay, so in next stage we are using the hysteresis band controller, hysteresis controller. It receive two input. So one is from that compensating current calculation, it going to be act as a reference current, and then actual current that shunt active filter, that means shunt active filter current is taken as actual current. So both are is processed to a hysteresis controller, and hysteresis controller generated the gating pulse for that shunt active filter. So this is going to be given to that shunt active filter. So it going to be inject the current in order to improve the power quality in the system and also compensate the current in the reactive power compensation in the power system. So next time we have to simulate this model. First I am going to explain about voltage mitigation in the power system by means of UPQC. So here you can see that initially the UPQ is not working, but here the UPQ is working here not to mitigate the voltage problem in the power system or load side. So here you can see that the harmonic generated in the source. So not to mitigate this problem, okay, the UPQ is going to be start working here. So because of this UPQC injection voltage, the load voltage is maintained constant at 2 per 1 per unit. So next you can see that the voltage sag is created in between 0.9 to 1. So now you can see that source voltage change from 1 per unit to 0.7. So now to maintain 1 per unit at the load side, the some voltage going to be injected from that UPQC. Okay, here also that voltage is going to be voltage sag going to be indicated here. So next you can see that here from 1.6 to 1.7, source voltage change from 1 per unit to 1.3 per unit. In order to maintain 1 per unit at load side, here UPQC is start working. Because of this UPQC, the load voltage maintained at 1 per unit. Here also the voltage swell going to be mitigated by means of UPQC. So from that we can conclude that the UPQC effectively mitigate the voltage problem in the system. So next time you have to explain the source current, right? That means the shunt active filter concept. The shunt active filter used for improve the power quality in the power system. That means it going to be compensate the reactive power, and then it going to be improve the current quality in the source side. So now we can see that. So the current quality is improved, is nearer to sinusoidal. Okay. So next you have to check the THD of that input current. So how much THD is reduced by means of that UPQC. Here the data stored in the grid underscore pi. Okay. So next you have to check the THD of the source current. Now we can see the THD value. This is 2.45, but without UPQC the THD is around for source current having 22.2%. That because of that UPQC the THD value change reduced from 22.22 to 2.45%. So the by means of UPQC the source current quality also improved very better than the normal operation. So from that finally I conclude that the UPQC effectively mitigate the voltage problem as well as improve the power quality in the source current and compensate the reactive power in the power system. So this model is already is available in the following website. So for example, you can go to this website itpes.net. So this is official website for that our YouTube channel, and then go to this download MATLAB file. So this file is available here. So and also we uploaded different MATLAB file for different application. So you can download this file for your application or project. So thank you for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much.